All right, so let's try this one. I have the integral from minus infinity to minus 5 of 1 over 2x plus 1 to the 4 dx. So as soon as I see that minus infinity, I know I have an improper integral of type 1. Type 1 means one of the bounds is infinite, if not both. And so I know I'm going to have to rewrite. Using a t, I replace minus infinity by t and sends t to minus infinity. So that bound being infinite, or minus infinity, that means really we're talking about a limit of definite integrals, not a real definite integral. All right, I have 2x plus 1 to the minus 4 dx. All right, so the limit will stay up front until we're done integrating, and then we'll use it. So now my job is to look at this integral and to evaluate it. I have a power, but what's inside is a bit too complicated. In fact, that probably means I should use a substitution. I have 2x plus 1 inside, and so du will be 2 dx. I'll get, if I plug in t, wait, so u instead of 2x plus 1 to the minus 4 dx. Let's figure out what dx is. So dx is 1 half du, and so I'm going to get 1 half du right here. And then I have to worry about the bounds. Remember, when you change variable, you change your bounds. So I have t, that's a bound for x. I'm going to plug it into this to get a bound for u. So here I'll get 2t plus 1. Sine from minus 5. I get 2 times minus 5 plus 1. All right, now I can integrate. I have u to the minus 4, so plus 1 minus 3 over minus 3 times 1 half, and then 2t plus 1. The other bound is minus 10 plus 1, that's minus 9. All right, we plug in the bounds. We're getting there. So I'm getting minus 9 to the minus 3 over minus 6 minus 2t plus 1 to the minus 3 over minus 6. All right, so the negative exponent means there should really be in the denominator. So I'll get t go to the minus infinity. I have minus, 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 so 1 over all the minuses cancel. And then on that side, same thing, 2t plus 1 cube. And so I get, I calculated it before, it's 4,374 plus 1 over minus infinity, 2t plus, yeah, minus infinity cubed. And so this part goes to 0. I end up with 1 over 4,374. Done. Right, so you can see that this is a very nice topic to end the course with. Well, we're not ending the course, but that to see at the end of the course, because we get to review all integration technique before the final. Right, so I really like this topic. Let's do another example next. So in the next video, we'll look at how to find an area of an unbounded region.